There we go. Oh, I like forgot how to play. So dark. The glowing lights are really beautiful, though. There we go. Wait, what is happening? Whoa. Guess it wouldn't hurt to put a spot here, just in case I fall. It's really windy outside. Oh. Oh. Sorry, my iPad keeps like freaking out on me. There we go. Is that where I came from? I hear more of those bugs. No, that isn't anything. Here we go. Oh. Jump or don't. It's just so hard to see. It's dark in here. Isa, thank you for your support. Thanks to you, we can continue to work to protect three humped saurians. Without your help, we would never have been able to renovate our shelter. I'm also happy to announce that the time has come. We've begun releasing some of our rescued saurians back into the wild. This time we're working with Sparkle Shroom growers to preserve shaded areas vital to saurians. I'm confident that reintroducing them back into their natural habitat will be a success. It's still unclear how we're going to help the remaining ones adapt to life on the Great Plain, but now that this first phase is complete, at least the species' survival is assured. Thank you again, An. You need to jump against the wall. Oh. That's what I was trying to do. Whoa. I see. Why? No, why do you keep doing that? He just keeps letting go. There we go. That's what I wanted. Whoops. Okay, wasn't sure if I was gonna make that. Something down here. Maybe up here. There's not really anything here. We continue to climb. Oh. I didn't even know that there was a growable plant up here. I guess I hit it when I called for the fireflies. Easy. Oh, did I hit something else that grew? Oh, yeah, there's a flower right there. Nice and easy. Probably should have, there we go. Placed up hidden a little bit earlier. I didn't, though. There we go. Would have been pretty bad if I fell. was gonna say, why are you not grabbing it? I don't think that's a climbable ledge. Oh, we're working our way back out of the mountain. What was that noise? Oh, here we go. Nothing to grow in here. Oh, could I have done it on this side too? I guess I could have. I don't know where I am. Okay, I can get up there. I don't know where exactly this is, though. Oh, someplace I climbed around? Whoa. Holy crap. Were we down there before? It's massive. Maybe not, though. like a bunch of coral. Wait. This maybe used to be part of the ocean? Or maybe this is just different breeds of cacti. I don't know. Yeah, it had to be. Like, this had to be ocean at one point. And this was a dam. It's very windy outside right now. Say no to locks. Water and people should be able to flow freely. We can't deny the many for the sake of the few. In the current crisis, it's our duty to stand in solidarity with living things. To confine the water is to confine us all. Regular information sessions at the Market Canteen, the White Water Collective. The White Water Collective. No one comes by anymore. I haven't sold a single flower. Should I switch careers? But I don't know how to do anything besides taking care of plants. I might as well write poetry, right? Or try to, at least. Roses are red, violets are blue. Where, oh where, has everyone gone to? Yeah. Time to climb. There's nowhere to climb here. Shit. Okay. Oh, come on. There we go. I don't see any other way to get further unless I do this. Oh, maybe that is what I was supposed to do. There we go. There we go. Brella Gazette, issue 37. 8 octaves and 2/5 after the Jusant. Editorial. In this issue of the Gazette, we'll be looking at an animal from the outside for once. The Weavebeak. Weavebeaks are the only animals found in every region of the Tower, every known region at least. Sometimes they even venture into our tunnels. These medium-sized birds are known for their all-white feathers and blue comb. It's not uncommon to see the playful birds gliding through the warm drafts and rise up the cliffs of the tower. They're also extremely curious and can often be found perched near climbing routes, observing and commenting on what's happening with their fellow birds. Not only are weavebeaks social creatures, they're also skilled builders. They work together to build their nests, which have multiple entrances and can house dozens of weavebeaks. They're constantly strengthening and expanding their nests and are always on the lookout for twigs, hence the expression working like a weavebeak. Did you know? Weavebeaks' combs open and close depending on their mood. A wide open comb means the weavebeak is alert or stressed about something or someone. But enough chatter. Keep reading for an in-depth look at the lives of these outwardly unassuming yet fascinating birds. Dear Editor, I've only read the editorial and I'm already outraged. It all sounds very nice, but you might want to think twice before publishing such nonsense. Weavebeaks are thieves. They're always stealing my wood to build their nests. I'm unsubscribing. Signed, a disgruntled citizen. Get a life, man. Oh. I right. I'm not entirely sure where it is. I'm trying to go. Up here, maybe. Why are you not grabbing, man? Made it. Climb him a decent distance and then put in a pit and just because, like right here. There we go. Oh, there we go. Why? He like doesn't hold his grip. Restore your stamina more than 50 times while climbing. Come on. Complete more than 200 jumps or double jumps in a game? Damn it! What are you doing? There we go. Jesus. That was hard. Oh. There's not even anything here. Oh, I see. Nice and easy. Don't fall. Is there like a checkpoint down this way? There is. I still don't really know what these do. Well, that's creepy. All right, I don't think there's anything down here. Time to go. Continue back up our journey. All right, like we made it back up. Yeah. All right, I'm not sure where we're at now. I think we're just still in the same cave. Definitely looks like this was underwater before. Ah, made it. Here we go. That makes climbing so much faster. Can I make this? Yes. So I can just ride it. Oh, that probably wasn't a good idea. Oh, I guess it was. Okay. Should probably rest for a second. I'm running out of rope. Whoa. Don't mind Lulu drinking. Oh, that's not a ladder. Oh, I see. Okay. Oh. I'm not sure I have the room to do that. Sorry, Ida. I have to go to the market. Their water inlet is acting up again. Things are starting to get complicated. I really thought that by holding back the water, but there's nothing to be done. The basins are empty. I think it's time for a more radical change. What would have happened if we'd let the water flow freely from the start? I'm boring you with my musings. But sometimes I get the feeling we've made a big mistake. There's a pier collapsing in the boatman's district. There's a pier collapsing in the boatman's district. Do you think you could take care of it? Hey, Joe. Things are non-stop at the moment. I'll have to go fishing for a new team to shore it up. Issa's already at the Two Pillars site. As for the other stuff, I don't know what to say. What's done is done. All right. I'll pick up the supplies I need, and then I'm off to the boatman's district. Hey, big guy. I hope you're well. You know, I still don't like the thought of you perched above that basin. It's too big. We just aren't made for the open air. You'd be better off in our tunnels, where it's cozier. You might have already heard, but Anne's barge is finally back on dry land. They can't drive it back anymore, they say, but you should see them now. They've never been so busy. They're working at a sore rescue center or some such thing. If you can believe it. Who'd want to save sours? Seriously? They always look so disgruntled, like they're judging us. But things haven't been easy for Anne, and they seem happy again. That's what matters. Your father played a song for you. It was beautiful. May the currents be with you. May the currents be kind to you wherever they are. Oh, come on. There we go. Oh, there's nowhere for me to climb here. I guess just to make sure I don't fall. Gotta be careful which ones I'm grabbing. We are the water surveyors. In the dark tunnels, we guide, clean, navigate rivers and streams. So the water called forth in the day the sky can fill, nourish, cherish all living things. Going. What the fuck? Can I even make this? This must be the boatman's area because there's some massive boats down there. A little bit lower. All right, here we go. Okay. Oh, we found another one. I love these, like, little vignette things. Like audio vignettes. We could hear them writing this. I often wonder what would have happened if the rain had returned. Would we still have met? Or would we have led parallel lives elsewhere, each of us unaware of the other's existence? As much as seeing the Great Basin dry up more with each sleep fills me with despair, I can't help but be happy by your side. Excuse me. Slowly working our way out of here. I'm assuming that's what we're doing, working our way up, up and out. Yeah, this all definitely used to be underwater. Like, there's coral everywhere. I wonder if I can make it down to that boat. Nope. I figured as much, but the QA brain in me wanted to see. Oh, whoa, look at the ceiling. Oh, I see. Oh, we found it! The next horn! There's two more. We're gonna fly, aren't we? My computer is kind of struggling with this. Whoa, we're very high up. Oh, look how green it is. Whoa, look how windy it is. Chapter 5, Mirage. Okay, I think it auto-saved. I am going to have to wrap up there, just because... my fiance is going to be home in about a half hour, and I need to get dinner going here. So if you're watching this on YouTube later, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.